Well, I think Senator Dodd began looking at the clock and realized that he was running out of time. I think he also realized that the exact week that the Banking Committee would be taking this up was the week that health care reconciliation may be happening in the Senate. And I think most importantly, as he continued to negotiate with me, he was losing Democrats as he moved more to the middle of the road. And I think at the end of the day, just decided it was probably more efficient, if you will, to draft a bill that had, would get 100% Democratic support in committee and try to solve the other issues to make it bipartisan down the road.
Where does it go from here and what's likely to happen?
So I think, the bill was, in print today, and obviously, I mean, it's the first time they've seen it too, because I know they were just finishing up concepts last night. I was on the phone with Senator Dodd till about 9:20 last night. So. I know that the concepts, much of which we were not involved in, were just generated over the weekend. They're seeing the print for the first time. Amendments will be done, will be introduced by Friday of this week. Now, this is a 1,300-page bill plus. And then next week in committee, we'll begin marking it up. And, Charlie, I just want to tell you, this is a very substantive bill. Some of the titles, every sentence matters. And we've had the advantage of over the last 35 days working on it 7 days a week into the wee hours every night. I can't imagine how a senator could possibly know what's in this bill, know what the amendments say, and vote it out of committee that quickly, but I'm pretty sure that's what's going to happen, and my guess is it'll vote out of committee on party line, which I regret, especially after all the work many of us have put into it.
So how disappointed are you now?
Look, I would do it again. I came up here. The people of Tennessee have given me a 6-year lease to try to solve problems that our country is dealing with, and I would do it again. I noticed about Tuesday night that I felt Senator Dodd was getting a little bit jittery about what was happening. I know that many of the Democrats were giving him a hard time about some of the things they were hearing that was in the bill. I called him Wednesday morning to sort of buck him up, if you will, and say, we can finish this. We're on the 5-yard line. At 3 o'clock, he came in and told me what was happening. Look, I'm a grown up. I understand that in the Senate, math counts. You have to have votes. I think he was probably getting some pressure from other places like the White House. And look, I think we've made the bill better. I know we've made the bill better. There's still a lot of issues that I hope we'll deal with in a very different way. So we do have a bipartisan bill. But look, I'm disappointed, but there's probably nobody on the Republican side that knows more about this bill now. And I hope we can use that knowledge and certainly what we've talked about over the last 35 days to make the bill better.
So you believe in the end financial reform and regulation will get Republican support?
Well, I hope so. I have gotten every indication from Senator Dodd that that's what he hopes to see happen. I know Senator Shelby, a ranking committee member, wants to see that happen. I think there are many Republicans that most Republicans, I think, want to see appropriate financial reform. So I think left to our own accord in the Senate, yes, that can happen. I haven't had any indication of this, but sometimes other forces want to see an issue or want to have an issue instead of a solution. Sometimes people factor those kinds of things into upcoming politics. I know the people of America are really disgusted with that kind of thought. I haven't seen any of that evident yet. And so, yes, sir, I would say that I think there's a really good chance of us getting a bipartisan bill, and we certainly want to be part of trying to make that happen.